Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Think of your application as a motorbike. Now, this particular bike has a lot of dependencies if it needs to work perfectly fine. For example, it needs brake, oil, chain. If something goes wrong, you need a wrench, spanner. So bike basically has dependencies on all these different set of tools. But you can't simply throw these tools everywhere. You need to manage it in a proper manner. So a best practice would be to put these tools into some kind of toolbox. But once again, you don't keep this particular toolbox anywhere. Most likely you have some kind of a workshop, and that is where you keep this particular toolbox. So now, with this particular analogy, let's try to understand where the container comes into picture. If you think your bike as a application, then all these tools that you need for your application to work perfectly fine are dependencies. And the toolbox that you use to keep these dependencies is nothing but the container. So that is where the word app container comes from. Now, what is the workshop? Workshop is nothing but your Android application class, the class that extends application. So with this understanding, let's try to implement the app container based dependency injection, which is nothing but manual dependency injection. So what we will do is, going back to the analogy, we are going to put all the tools in the toolbox. So let me put the tools here. And once again, here dispatchers, we are directly initializing as a hidden dependency. It would be better to not to do this. So what I will do is, I will create a dispatcher here, and default value, I will keep it as IO dispatcher, so that it basically comes through the explicit dependency. So now you have the app container ready, that is the toolbox is ready with the tools. But then we need the workshop. And how do we create the workshop? You create a application class. So let me just create a new Kotlin class, country info application, which extends Android application. And inside this, let me create application container. And let me initialize it by lazy initialization. And I will invoke the constructor and pass context. And with this, my workshop is also ready. But we have forgotten one thing, which is we need to declare this particular country info application in the manifest file. So let me just open the manifest file. Application name, country info application. So now this class officially becomes my Android application class. Now let me go back to the country info app scaffold. Now what I can do is get rid of this particular code, and I will write val app container. And how will I access it? Through the context, context dot application context as country info application. So I am basically typecasting it into a country info application. Once I have it as a country info application, I can access the application container. So to create the both of these view models, we need to slightly modify the view model factory. So let me go here. I will rewrite this particular view model factory so that it basically returns both the types of view models, that is country UI view model and country operation view model. My app container is having this view factory. Now, once I have this particular country view model factory, I can initialize it through app container. So what I will do is view model app container dot view model factory dot create country UI view model class Java. And in case of operation view model, once again this part of the code changes, app container view model factory dot create country operation view model. So now all the dependencies are coming from the app container, which is defined in the country info application. And this is how the manual dependency injection looks like. However, there is still scope to improve this. There will be certain people who would say that this particular app container is not thread safe. So it would be better to make sure that it is thread safe, and also it is a singleton. Already it is singleton to some extent because it is getting initialized through country info application, which is a singleton class by design in Android, because you always get only one instance of the application. But in case if there are multiple activities, there might be a situation where multiple instances of activity application might get created. So to make sure that you always get only one single instance of the app container, what we can do is we can create a slightly a better refined version of this particular app container. So let me show you how that looks like. Let me call it as singleton app container. It will pretty much have all the same things. We will pass the private constructor with the context to this singleton. Let me resolve the dependencies here, and then let's create a companion object which returns this singleton app container. Now let me go back to the country info application. What we will do is we will create another val application container by lazy, and inside, instead of using the app container, we will use singleton app container dot get instance this. And now this is even a better design than what we had implemented with a normal app container. So whether you use this particular app container or a singleton app container, you are pretty much well covered. So just to be sure that we have not broken any code, let me rerun the application. Yeah, application is working fine. So we have successfully refactored our code. So if I want to summarize what we did to do the manual dependency injection built into our application, let me just go through the changes that we did through the Git here. So we created the app container, and then we created the country info application with the app container built into it. So now the country application has the application container. We even defined a better implementation of the app container to make sure that it is a singleton. So you can basically use this or this. This one is without singleton and this one is with singleton. And then in the scaffold, we got hold of the app container through the application context and used that to instantiate the view model. So now all our dependencies will be served through the app container, which is like a centralized toolbox that is there in the country info application, which is a workshop. So with this mechanism, our dependency injection is much better than what we were doing earlier. However, there is still a problem with this particular approach. The problem is, if you go to the scaffold, this is a hidden dependency. If you want to change this during the testing time, you can't change because this is not explicit. And of course, you can move this particular part of the code to activity. Let me show you how to do that. This is application. But in spite of that, let's assume that you pass this application container here. To some extent, you make it explicit, but if you want to change it at the testing time, you can't really change. It is not easily mockable. So for small application, this might work very well, but for very large scale applications, using this manual dependency injection with the container based approach is not really a very good idea. So in that case, what do we do? So that is exactly where the dependency injection frameworks like Dagger and Hilt come into picture. So in the next upcoming videos, we will actually start going through some of these dependency injection frameworks.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.